On this webpage, the International Chair on Cardiometabolic Risk provides a step-by-step video on how to self-measure your waist circumference. Numerous studies have shown that measuring abdominal waist circumference is the best, simplest way to estimate how much abdominal fat you have. However, you have to know how to interpret measurement results in order to determine whether they indicate high-risk abdominal obesity. Based on the relationship with body mass index, BMI, threshold values for overweight, 25 kg per meter square, or obesity, 30 kg per meter square, organizations such as the National Cholesterol Education Program Adult Treatment Panel 3, the NCEP ATP3, have proposed waist circumference values of 102 cm for men and 88 cm for women. These values correspond to a BMI of 30 kg per meter square. However, BMI is limited as it cannot be used to establish valid waist cutoffs to predict potential additional risk. Furthermore, age and ethnicity affect the relationship of waist circumference to intra-abdominal fat and related health risk. For instance, we know that Asians are more prone to diabetes for a given waistline, and that this phenomenon may be partly due to the fact that Asians are more likely to store intra-abdominal fat than Caucasians. In addition, African Americans are more likely to store fat subcutaneously than Caucasians. A single cutoff of 102 cm in men and 88 cm in women may therefore be unsuitable for defining excess abdominal fat in all populations worldwide. An International Diabetes Federation, IDF, committee on the metabolic syndrome attempt to address this problem in its 2005 guidelines. Table 1 summarizes IDF waist circumference values according to ethnicity and gender. However, these values have not been validated against hard clinical outcomes and therefore provide ballpark figures to patients and their treating physicians. This table has been endorsed by the recent Canadian guidelines on obesity, which have also emphasized that waist measurement is a vital sign that needs to be assessed in clinical practice. But, as mentioned above, men, women, and various populations differ in their susceptibility to store abdominal fat and in their relationship to diseases. Waist circumference values used to define abdominal obesity should therefore be gender and population specific.